Hello friends, welcome to Abhinav Goswami Law Classes. So friends, in this video we are going to discuss a very important case law. The name of the case is Headley versus Baxendale. This is a case of 1854, a very old English case law. So friends, as far as this case is concerned, why this case is so important is it tells you about what will be the extent of damages in cases of breach of contract. Extent of damages. So what happened in this case, friends, was that there is this company, okay, a particular mill. So they have to rely on their machines for their work, everyday work, right? So there is a device that is used in that machine. The name of the device is crankshaft. So it is a very essential component of that machine. Without that, the machine can't run. The mill can't work. Okay, so that was broken because of some reason. Then what happened? This mill owner contacted the manufacturer of these mills, this crankshaft. And the manufacturer said that, okay, if you want us to make a new shaft for you, you have to send your old shaft. And then according to that model, we will make a new shaft and send that back to you. Okay, this was the scenario. Then what happened? This old shaft, which was there. So this manufacturer is far away from these people, from the mill owner. So what he did, he took that shaft and delivered it to a carrier. Carrier means a person who works in this thing, who delivers goods from one place to another. Okay. So he was a carrier. So this person, the owner of the mill, delivered that broken shaft to this carrier. Then this carrier was supposed to deliver that broken shaft to the manufacturer. Okay. So what happened? This carrier took a lot of time to deliver that crankshaft to the manufacturer, because of which for many days the mill was closed and there was huge loss of profits to this mill owner. Okay, so what this mill owner did, he sued this carrier. He said that because of your negligence, I had to suffer this huge loss of so many days when I could not work in my mill. My mill could not function because of your delay, because of your negligence. If you would have delivered that broken shaft to the manufacturer at the right point of time, I would not have suffered so much of the loss. So he is suing for the damages. So what do you think? Is this mill owner entitled to the damages, the loss of profits that he is claiming from the carrier? So in this case, the court got the opportunity to actually analyze that no doubt there is a breach of contract. Carrier took an obligation that I will deliver the shaft in this much of the days. Okay. And he actually delayed that thing and he did it negligently. Both of these facts show that he has breached the contract. That is clear. That is not an issue. Contract has been breached. But what will be the extent of damages? How much compensation or money will have to be paid? And what are the things that will be taken into consideration by the court of law when deciding that amount of damages is the main issue in this case? So the first thing the court held in this case was that in every case of breach of contract, the party who is claiming damages is entitled to ordinary damages. Ordinary damages means the damages which are natural, which can naturally be expected by the other party to result from the breach of contract, from the actions that the other party is doing. Okay, so you are always entitled to natural damages which the other party can expect to arise because of the breach. Okay. Now the question arises, what are ordinary damages? What are natural consequences of breach of contract? They are such damages which the other party, without any additional information, can make out from the fact itself. There is no requirement of any additional or special knowledge on the part of the other party. So all these damages which this party can think by himself or herself, that as I have breached this contract, this much damages must not normally occur to the other person. These are ordinary damages. Okay. So normally in any case of breach of contract, the party suing is entitled to these ordinary damages. And if the party, if this party who is suing for damages want to claim special damages, then it is necessary that the other party must be aware about these special circumstances. What are these special damages? Special damages, as in this case, because you are not claiming damages only because a contract has been breached, but you are claiming profit, loss of profit that has occurred because of it. Okay, that is a special damage. That, as a normal understanding, as a normal person, the defendant would not never have thought that if I delayed this thing, loss of profit will occur to this person. Why? Because it is not necessary, you know, just because a crankshaft is being delivered to the carrier, this owner of the carrier can't be supposed to know that the mill is closed because of this. It may happen that the mill owner may have another shaft with him, extra shaft with him, and mill may be still functioning. This is also possible, no? So there is no clarity from the only fact itself that because a shaft has been delivered, that the carrier must be aware that mill is closed. We can't presume, we can't put that presumption on this such a person, because there can be other possibilities also. So for this reason, special damages can't be claimed from this carrier, because he was not made aware specifically that because of this crankshaft, our mill is closed. So please try to deliver it as soon as possible. So as the carrier was not made aware about the special circumstances, therefore, for that reason, no special damages can be claimed from the defendant, for the reason that he was actually not aware that because of the delay of this carrier, loss of profit is happening to the appellant, to the petitioner in this case. Okay, so for this reason, the damages will limit to the ordinary consequences which the other party could expect, not nothing special. So friends, this is what the rule is, and it is still continuing. So in every case, the court has to see what will a normal person will think about the damages, what are the kind of damages will occur in a normal course. And if any special damages being claimed, whether the other party who has actually breached the contract was aware of those special circumstances or not. Okay. So these both of these facts are still taken into consideration in everyday cases. So friends, I hope you have understood what I was trying to say with the help of this case law. So friends, if you want to appreciate my efforts, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. The link is in the description to the video. And if you want to connect with me on Telegram, I hold live sessions every day. If you want to be a part of it, please join my Telegram group. The invitation link to my Telegram group is also in the description to the video. Until then, friends, be safe, be happy. I'll see you very soon.